Hey, Swaggy Swan family, thanks for tuning in. Let's do a quick recap of the last video where I showed you how to continue to grow your child's hair healthily and what kind of routine that you can do in the summer, which consisted of still applying your aloe vera moisturizing hair treatments from the great aloe vera leaf, growing your child's hair from a baby, from that to this, how to maintain that, especially in the crazy heat of summer and all the things that come with summer hair care. So to start off with, now that we did our quick recap of the last video, all of your summer hair care routines for your child should be on clean hair first. She's getting her hair washed. Savannah is a toddler. If you're new to this page and wondering if you're an oldie but goodie, thank you for always being supportive. So yeah, you're gonna wanna always wash your child's hair before you put in any type of protective style. I did promise you guys I was gonna go over some of the protective styles that I like, because you guys have recently been seeing her in pictures via our social media where you see Savannah, she has had braids in her hair, specific kind of braids. I don't do all different kinds of braids, but there are some that I find to be really helpful for your child's hair that help it to grow, help you to not have to do much to it, especially during the summertime. And with all the things you're possibly doing in the summer, such as vacationing, activities, more outdoor activities where there's dry heat, lots of reactions from the environment on the hair that can be harsh, the braids tend to be most helpful in my opinion when I need a long lasting protective style. So Savannah's hair gets washed very thoroughly. You want to make sure the hair is super clean and completely stripped of any dirt and any remnants of just gook and nasty stuff that kind of builds up, especially in the summer. Now, Savannah sweats a lot. She does get that from me, and I sweat a lot in my hair. So with that being said, thorough washing is very important. So wash your child's hair first. The style you see here that you've been seeing her wear, if you do follow us on social media, is referred to as knotless braids. Now, here's what I like about the knotless braids. They are essentially tension-free. So if you get someone to do it the right way, when done correctly, it is not pulling at the hair. So it's definitely great for young children. I would recommend it. And also it lasts really long. I like to add beads to the ends of Savannah's hair when she's getting some type of braiding style, because I think beads are super cute for little girls. And I also think that beads just kind of make it even more fashionable and cute. And I prefer to sometimes get colors that will go with a lot of outfits, because again, the point of the protective style, especially in the summer, is so that I don't have to do much to her hair. Not doing a lot to your child's hair is going to help it grow, in addition to the certain products you use, but having to constantly wash it, constantly doing things to it because their hair may be getting dirty, and then the style just looks like, oh my gosh, it's time for a new style, let me add more ponytails, or let me add more, no, cut all of that out, guys. Make your life easier. Start to understand and find someone if you don't know how to braid, because I am not the best braider, but I know how to find people, whether it be family or utilizing social media to find someone who specializes in kids braids locally. I would encourage you to do that, because not only is it going to give you a break, more importantly, taking care of their hair in a protective style is going to help their hair to grow. So as you can see, very cute and simple. The beads are added with a beading tool that they use now, and then just wrapped with a band at the end with the last bead. Plenty of videos on YouTube about it. So if you don't want to tackle trying to do knotless braids in your child's hair on your own, again, use your resources to find someone who specializes in it. Trust me, you're going to be really excited, and it's worth it. And again, they're not in pain, which is most important. As you can see, Savannah is literally, per usual, playing on her iPad or in her own world. She just gets frequent breaks. Before you know it, it's done. And it's so good, especially for the pool. So if your child really is a fan of the beach, water, pool water, Definitely, I would say knotless braids is the way to go for the summertime for protecting their hair. It lasts so long. You really can get weeks worth out of the hairstyle, which is ideal, honestly. And there's so many different things you can do to it. Half up, half down, switch it up with different colored scrunchies, hair bows, and stuff like that. It's really one of the most affordable, and I think it's worth it for the price, I guess, depending on where you are. But for me, that style is like a great go-to for the summer, guys, all while protecting your child's hair. Real quick, if you have been going crazy on the website, which is always in the description box, ordering, please know orders are always being put together. You guys order a whole lot, and that's why a lot of the products are usually sold out for the authentic Jamaican black castor oil and the aloe vera moisturizing hair treatment. But always stay tuned and keep checking the site when it's in stock. I always recommend definitely stock up if you can. I mean that wholeheartedly, because I get so many emails of people saying, oh my gosh, it's sold out again. Oh my gosh, it's sold out. Just, I don't know, join the email list, stay abreast to what's going on, and stock up, because this stuff works. But back to the video. I already know someone's probably gonna ask, what if your child is younger? For example, young, like how Savannah was here, where she was X amount of months old, but still not a toddler. I know someone's gonna ask me, what can you do in the summertime to protect your child's hair for its protective style and still help it to grow and flourish if they are younger? So if your child is younger, around this age, like you see here, where they have some length to their hair, or at least enough where you wanna try to do stuff to protect it, here's what I say. Always make sure you're detangling with a good detangling brush in the summertime. Still wash their hair before attempting any style. And I would actually recommend more of the cornrow style, like you see Savannah wearing here. So getting the hair actually cornrowed versus knotless braids is actually age appropriate for even that younger age of kids. You can still grab the hair nicely, firmly, but not tightly, and be able to collect the hair and put it in a protective style via cornrows like this. So I would definitely recommend that. If you feel like your child is at an age where they can use beads like this, then I would say go for it. But just be cautious about the beads, because if they are at the age where they're too young and they will pull at their beads, that is a safety hazard. So you can eliminate the beads and just do the braids in itself, and kind of maybe decorate or accessorize it with nice, cute, safe headbands or scrunchies. So voila, nice parting, very neat. Again, you would still try to attempt to braid if you know how, or look for a local braider who also can do cornrows even in children's hair. So something I like to do is, I still like to make her edges nice and cute with this black gel here, this Pro Styler gel. The Eco Professional Styling Gel is nice, but I noticed with Savannah's hair, in a couple of hours, it's like I never put gel in it, so that's why I opt to using the black one. And all I do is take a soft bristle brush, and I still do the baby hairs on the outer lining of any type of braiding style that she has gotten. So you can still do that. If you're not a fan of the baby hairs, then skip that step. No big deal, right? All right, so I just take that soft bristle brush. Please do not do baby hairs with a hard bristle brush or a very hard toothbrush. Just try to find a soft bristle brush and softly assess, apply, and smooth down those baby edges when they have their cornrow or knotless braid style. Voila, your kid's happy. Okay, and that is how you're gonna keep their hair nice and flourishing. And still remember to use your aloe vera moisturizing treatments or the aloe vera plant itself. You can still do that when they have the braids, if you want to, throughout the scalp, and then you can spray it with water. I'll do another video on that. But honestly, you could still just apply both these hair growth treatments on the wash day before you do the protective style in your child's hair. Hope this information was helpful, guys, so you know what to do to help your child's hair grow and be protective as a summer hair care routine. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. We'll see you soon. God loves you, and we love you too.
It happened.
Put it on wrong. What does the cat do? What does the cat say? What does a lion do?